when a baby is born, a baby is born in a state. The state is called pure and innocent. Every child that's born is born what?
Pure and innocent.
Pure and innocent. There's no child that's born using profanity. There's no child that's born in a gang, smoking marijuana, carrying 40 calibers and Glocks. That ain't what the state that a child is born in. So the question that we have to ask is, how does a baby go from being pure and innocent to killing their parents? Just happened. Didn't it just happen yesterday?
Day before yesterday.
Day before yesterday? I mean, this pure little cuddly, beautiful, adorable child, how did this child get so damaged that the child killed the parents? How can a young man become so damaged that he will shoot a pregnant girl in the head? She begging for her life. Then she fall down and shoot her three more times. What happened to this young man that caused him to do this? And we're going to find out tonight how this manifested itself. When a baby is born, a baby has emotional needs. Emotional needs that have to be fulfilled. When those needs are not fulfilled, non-secure attachment takes place, mistrust takes place, and the child now goes into a world of fantasy and imagination about the source of the pain, because there's no one there to translate why the pain is happening. Now, we're going to erase this purity and innocence from the heart. And we're going to find out what the emotional needs are. Who can tell me what one of the first emotional needs of a child is? Olivia.
Love.
Love. Why is love so important?
Nurturing.
Caring.
Yeah.
Love. This is an emotional need. Now, love is a two-way street. Is that right? Mm-hmm. Huh? If you're in a relationship and you're giving out love, you're not receiving love, is that an imbalance? Mm-hmm. Now, children naturally come into the world loving. And the reason that children are born is to show us how far away from the mark we are. That's why we be so happy when we see them. Man, I remember one time I was like this. Right? They're just pure, innocent, cuddly, adorable. And they give love, but oftentimes they don't do what? They don't receive love. And they feel it in their what?
Heart.
A child's cognitive faculties is not developed. So they can't think, so they do what?
Feel.
Most people don't think. They feel first, they act second, then they think later on. Man, I shouldn't have shot the dude, man. Maybe I wouldn't have got 50 years. No, I mean, you should have thought about that on the front end. But you just felt, and you acted out, right? So love, what's the second emotional need?
Safety.
Pardon me?
Safety, security.
No, sir. That comes with what? Anything that you love, you're gonna make sure it's safe, and you're going to support it, it's going to be secure. What's the second? Mr. Alexander.
Taught.
Who?
Taught.
That's third. Communication. Communicate. You have to communicate to the child. You have to say affirmative things to the child. You have to support the child. You have to acknowledge the child. You have to encourage the child. Not yell at the child, scream at the child, curse at the child, or just not acknowledge the child at all. It's called communication. Communication is a two-way street. Communication seeks to do two things. I'm talking to you. I want you to understand. You're going to say something back to me. I want to be understood. And what happens is, in a lot of homes, communication doesn't take place. Criticism and condemnation. Because you have a lot of parents who are wounded just like the child. And they pass down their wounded feelings to the child. So there's no communication. The last need is to be what?
Taught.
The teacher teaches what the teacher is. And the child will learn from the teacher good or bad, and then the child is going to teach what they what? Learn. So if you use a profanity, the child's going to pick up profanity, and the child's going to start doing what?
Cursing.
But then you can't whoop the child for using profanity because the child picked it up from who?
Me.
From you. You don't show the child any love, and then the child grows up and don't show you any love. You can't become upset with the child. Because the child is teaching what the child learned from the what?
Parent.
From the teacher. Now, when the child is born, who is the child born to?
People.
Some who?
People.
People. Child is born to some people. As the child grows older, the people begin to take on distinct titles and roles. Called who?
Parents.
Call who?
Family.
Call who?
Neighbors.
So called.
Yep.
Right. This so called. Right. This is where it's trained really drums the track at. Because most children don't know themselves, so they don't know how to who's who, right? And then they live in a what? These are the child's first educators. This is called the takes a village to raise a what? A child. Now the child is still pure and innocent, but this is where the train jumps the track, because the child is born to some who?
People
that have some issues, that have some contradictions, that have some unresolved dynamics that they have not resolved that they pass on to the child. Now, these people, parents, relatives, and friends, they have to know how to, they have to know how to what?
To
be, right? Shakespeare said it best, to be or not to be, that is the question. You have to know how to be a good parent. You have to know how to be a loving relative. You know how to be a good friend, you have to know how to be a community. And if you know how to be, the child is going to know how to what?
Be.
But now, if you don't know how to be, then you're going to put on a what?
Act.
And then the child is going to begin to do what?
Act like.
Instead of to be. Like, you ever heard someone tell their child you need to act like you got some sense? No, don't act like it, man. Have some sense. This is how you have sense. But if the parent does not know how to be, then the parent can't teach the child how to be, so the parent, the child is going to act. So what we do here is we're teaching something to the children. Trying to teach them the importance of what?
Character.
How to be healthy, rational, intelligent, functional citizens. When a person does not have character, then they begin to what?
Act
crazy, act hard, act like a gang banger, act dumb. And then they become what?
An actor.
And these children are acting out because they are not around genuine, authentic people that know how to what?
Be.
The people are full of contradiction. Now, in this room, how many people, by honesty, truth will set you free? Because what happened, we got to disclose ourselves. Because you can't expect the child to disclose to you when you don't want to disclose about yourself, right? And this is how you begin to win trust of children. Because when I facilitate a class, I tell them about myself. And then I establish affinity with them, and then they begin to relax, right? How many people have ever experienced hate from their parents? Raise your hand. When you need love, you got hate. How did it make you feel, Mr. Bill Brown?
Confused.
That's how these children are feeling. They feeling what? Confused. Man, my parent, my mom, my dad, the person that is dear to me, showed me some what? When I needed some what?
Love.
Man, what's going on here? Who else? Raise their hand.
Angry.
A lot of these children are coming with what?
Anger.
Them children that killed their parents, but they